This morning's guest has been marching for babies for over 40 years. Who is she? You'll meet her coming up next on Carolina People. Good morning. Welcome to Carolina People. This morning we're at Coastal Grand Mall, the Grand Strand's premier shopping destination. We're focused on this Monday's signature chef's auction for the March of Dimes. And we're visiting with the past chairman of the event over a three-year period, the Honorable Lois Eargle, Horry County's auditor. Good morning, Lois.
Good morning.
Do you mind if I call you Lois instead of the Honorable? Not that you're not honorable, obviously.
I'd rather you call me Lois.
Lois is okay.
Plain old Lois.
You're plain old Lois. You are not plain old Lois. I know you well enough to know that it is not in your vocabulary.
I feel so like I'm not. You've had such wonderful guests this week.
This week has been a great week. You know, we kicked off the week with Patty Gresko and Kathleen Burroughs, the co-chairs of the 24th annual Taste of the Town, which was held on Tuesday night. John Robitaille, who's the upcoming general chair of that event, was on Tuesday, the day of Taste the Town. I think on Wednesday, Myra Starnes was with us.
She's a lovely lady.
She's amazing, promoting the 26th annual Charles Dickens show and festival.
I remember when she started that.
Do you really?
I sure do.
26 years ago. And then yesterday, we had a very interesting gentleman, Jim Rosenberg, the new president and chief executive officer of the Burroughs and Chapin Company. Fascinating guy.
He is, and I think he's going to do quite well, and he's going to fit in real well in this area.
I think you told me he was coming with you and Joe Fisher to the chef's auction on Monday night.
He is. He said that he was going to be our guest, and I'm really excited about our chef's auction. He just gets, as my grandmama used to say when I was growing up, she'd say, it gets gooder and gooder.
It gets gooder and gooder. I love it. And it really does, Lois. Obviously, it's been tough not having you chairing it this year, but Rigby Wilson is doing a crackerjack job, the new general manager of Fox TV, WFXB, my old station.
Yes.
Right here, the station we're airing.
I'm telling you, they're really going places.
Gangbusters,
Can't keep up with them.
Family-owned company out of Charlotte. Mm-hmm. They own the Fox affiliate in Charlotte, ABC in Columbia, WOLO, and now Fox TV here in Myrtle Beach, Florence, Lumberton, and Laurinburg. Great TV market.
Yes. And they have, they are so community-minded. That's what impresses me about them.
Oh, yeah. Rigby is, it's so tough to follow in Lois Eargle's footsteps, though. Isn't that, you meet a lot of folks say, you know, I had to do this after Lois, after you, Lois.
Yeah.
It's been no fun.
Well, they'll do well, and we'll have a success. Yeah. We've got 15 or 16 restaurants that's coming to fix their specialty, whatever it happens to be, from steak to all kind of good desserts.
Even fondue. I met the Iron Chef, Tommy, I think his name is, at the Melting Pot.
Yes.
Who's going to be coming in. I think it's maybe one of their first times being at the Signature Chef's Auction, the Melting Pot.
Yeah. The chefs who participate in our Chef's Auction tell me that they enjoy that event more than any other event that they participate in. They've told me that every year.
Is that right?
And it's just, the people are so great. And the atmosphere is just so congenial and it's wonderful.
It is. The Myrtle Beach Convention Center Hotel, the Sheraton, is the location of the chef's auction again this year.
That's right. And, of course, we have our premier sponsor this year is the one and only Greg Everett.
Oh, no, not me. It's this little weekly newspaper that we got.
Myrtle Beach Herald.
How about it?
Every time I think about Myrtle Beach Herald, I think Greg Everett.
Oh, that's very kind. You know, Jim Rosenberg said yesterday before the interview, this was great, Lois, traveling around the country to meet so many of the shareholders of Burroughs and Shape, and he came across many folks as far away as Chicago who said, why aren't we getting our Myrtle Beach Herald anymore?
You are teasing.
That's the way they would keep up with what was happening in the Myrtle Beach area.
Well, that's one way, because you know, they focus on local, which I love, you know.
Oh, yeah.
And then our Emerald sponsor this year is Johnny Suzuki.
Johnny Dangerfield and Johnny Suzuki coming on strong out there on Highway 501.
Aren't they, though?
What a beautiful location.
Yes. And he owns six dealerships across the
Come on.
Of the state.
I saw their magnificent facility down in Charleston. I didn't know he owned six.
Yes, he does. And from Greenville on down to Myrtle Beach.
They're doing
quite well and love the area.
Oh, yeah.
They said that they just love the community.
They
want to participate, and everything that we ask them to do, they always are glad to help us out.
I saw a great picture of Johnny Dangerfield and the Honorable Lois Eargle in the Myrtle Beach Herald and Hilda Carter's column, because he and his group, I think, are sponsoring the 40 most powerful women, or the 40 women of Horry County. Is that something that you helped kick off, Lois?
Yes, I decided, well, it's time for us to honor some of those women that are elected in positions like, you know, judges, real estate folks, insurance people. And so I was talking to them about it. They said, well, we'll be glad to sponsor that.
Why don't you talk to the Herald about co-sponsoring that, Lois? We put something behind it and help really wrap that up.
We got you on the list.
Yeah, good. You keep us in mind. Yeah. We'd love to do that. I tell you, I saw in reading about Myra Starnes, she, like you, was recognized by some local magazine as one of the 30 most powerful women in Horry County. I thought, why are those folks pumping up that magazine? We can help honor strong and women who've done a lot in the area.
We have so many women in this area who have done so much, who are continuing to be leaders in whatever field they happen to be in.
Horry County's probate judge, Horry County's clerk of court, Horry County's auditor, and many other amazing
women. Horry County has the Chief Justice of the Appellate Court.
The Court of Appeals, Kay Hearn, that's right.
Yeah, and she's running for Supreme Court.
I saw that. Do you think she has a good shot?
She does.
Does she really?
Yeah. She's a lovely lady and would do a wonderful job.
Of course, and another amazing woman, Jean Toll.
Yes.
Who's the Chief Justice of the South Carolina Supreme Court.
We're the only state in the United States that has two women that heads up the appellate courts.
Two branches of the judiciary in the state. Wow, I did not know that.
Yes.
That's amazing. Of course, Myrtle Beach's chief judge, Judge Jennifer Wilson, is also chief judge, who's an amazing gal. A lot of women doing wonderful things in the area, Lois. Does that surprise you? Is that surprising to you, having grown up in Sumter and having lived in Horry County for as long as you have?
It does in a way, but you know, whenever I was first elected in 1976, I think I was the first woman to ever run for
31 years ago.
But I think that that people have realized that women can do a good job at whatever that they happen to dedicate themselves to, whether it be an elected position, appointed position, or volunteer position. And the women who have led the way have done such a wonderful job until it has expanded and expanded. And I think we've just got a lot more to come.
Oh, yeah.
I'm real excited about it, yes.
I can tell. I can see it. You're leaning up on a Friday morning. I love it. That's a great testament. And, of course, you're leaning up also excited about the chef's auction. And, folks, they need to be calling the phone number today, the 488-3463. They can still line up tickets. They could even line up a table. I think Crystal and Colleen have both said if you want to sign up, and even on Monday, folks can still get tickets.
They can
even buy a table today.
Yeah, the tables are $1,500 for a table, and the tickets are $150 each.
Right.
The thing about it is you get to taste around almost 20 different kinds of foods that are so popular in this area. And as you well know, it's very good. Very good.
Why does the March of Dimes need the money, Lois?
Well, the March of Dimes, there's one in eight babies that are born are born premature.
One in eight babies are born premature.
And you know something? They're just doing a lot of research to find out why. Because even women who take care of themselves, who do the right things, eat the right things, exercise, still things happen.
Right.
And so we are just continuing doing research. We have the closest NICU unit that we have by our area is in Florence.
When you say NIC, you don't mean nicotine. You mean neonatal intensive care.
That's exactly right. For those little babies that they have all these incubators and things that they have to put them in. March of Dimes has played a part in the equipment that they use.
Really?
Also, in Horry County, whenever a baby is born premature, it has to go to Florence. We furnish, March of Dimes furnishes a ambulance to take them there.
Is that right?
Yes,
I did not know that.
Yes.
I didn't know that.
Of course, you know, it comes out of Florence, but the March of Dimes, they provide the money.
That is fantastic. At McLeod, the regional health care facility up there. They're an amazing operation.
I've been there, Greg, and it's the most humbling experience you'll ever have.
Really?
Because when you go in there and all those babies are lined up in those units.
Oh, yeah.
There's not one sound because they're too weak to cry. You know, and then to know that you've had a part in maybe their lives and helping them to live, because we have testimonies from parents who've had babies that weighed less 1 pound and 4 ounces, 2 pounds and six ounces, and that survived.
Born less than a pound and four ounces or a pound. Wow.
And so, and they have survived because of what the March of Dimes has provided for their care.
Lois.
And they'll tell you, if it hadn't been for the good Lord and the March of Dimes, their baby would not be here. That's right. And it's every time you hear one of them give a testimony, it just touches right in your heart, you know.
I know. Well, a lot of folks will be giving testimonies. Some of the parents that have come through very, very tough times. I think some of their children will even be there on Monday night. That alone would be worth making the $150 donation or even $300 for
a
couple to go.
And you can take that off your taxes, too.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. A big portion of that can come off of taxes. Taxes is something you know about. We want to talk more about the amazing lineup. I want to read off some of the confirmed restaurants. But at the same time, real quick, for viewers who may have recently gotten their tax notices, I believe some went up, some may have even gone down.
That's right.
What's the reason for that? And exactly how does the auditor's office fit into the mix there, Lois?
Okay. Well, now this, the auditor and the treasurer and the assessor, we work very close together.
Right.
The assessor assembles the information.
Right.
I send out the bills.
Right.
And the treasurer collects the money.
Okay, good.
So, and this year we sent out over 300,000 notices.
300,000
tax notices.
That's to personal residences and to businesses.
And got 299,000 calls.
Oh, I bet. Yeah.
I'm just.
Probably a lot of calls.
We got a lot of calls about them because of the fact what you were talking about. Some got tax breaks and some did not. The people in Horry County voted in November for a 1 cent sales tax statewide.
Right, right.
And what that did was it took off the school operating taxes from your primary home. That is, if you are getting the 4%.
Right.
That in South Carolina allows you to each individual person to have one primary home.
Okay.
And then if you, the second homes, then you don't get a tax break. You charge the regular, the 6%.
Right.
And so if you didn't get a tax break on some of your homes, maybe it's because, you know, that might be your second home.
Right.
But your primary home, you should. And let me tell you, be sure that if that's your primary home, that you are getting the 4%. Because I have signed people up this year that thought they were getting it, and they did not get it.
No.
And if you do not come into office, if you have not come into the office and signed up the assessor's office, you have to sign up for the 4% in the assessor's office.
In the assessor's office.
Right.
That is there in the judicial complex in Conway.
That's right. Then when you do that, that qualifies you for the 1 cent sales tax break for the school operating taxes, which is wonderful. And also, if you're 65 years old or older or disabled, 100% disabled, then that qualifies you for homestead exemptions.